I'm Professor Vishal Taylor. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you the maximum suction lift or a suction height. In this video, we derive the equations for a maximum suction lift. Now, what is the meaning of maximum suction lift? Means, it is the maximum height of the suction pipe. Suppose we are installing this pump and we are thinking that we are putting the suction pipe that slant is 1 kilometer and they are suck the water from the 1 kilometer depth. So it is not possible. That have a certain equations to finding out the maximum length of the suction pipe. Okay, so we deriving these equations by applying the energy equations. So these are the figures of a centrifugal pump. This is the centrifugal pump. This is the impeller. This is the suction pipe. And this is the height of the suction pipe HS. HS means the water level in a sump to the distance, means at the center of the pump, it is known as the HS, and VS is the velocity of the water in the suction pipe. So considering the centrifugal pump as shown in the figure, which lift a liquid from a sump, and the free surface of the liquid is at the depth of HS below the center of this impeller. This is the center of the impeller, this is the water surface, this is known as the HS, that is the suction head. Okay. Now, before moving ahead, I request to subscribe my channels by pressing subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get continuous notifications. Now we applying the energy equations at the free surface of the liquid and inlet of the impeller. So we are applying the Bernoulli's equations or energy equations, and this is the one surface. For that we require two sections. So this is a section, that is atmospheric section. Okay. And this is a section 1-1, means it is at the center of this impeller. So at the where is the water level, that is known as the sump, and in the at the sump, that is the atmospheric conditions. Okay, so that we are using the atmospheric terms, and for a impellers we are using the one term. So we applying this Bernoulli's equation and energy equations at the sump, that is a pressure energy, that is P atmosphere upon rho g, plus water velocity in a sump, that is and velocity energy V atmosphere square upon 2g plus depth, that is a Z atmosphere, equal to the energy at the inlet of the impeller, that is all the term denoted as the one, that is a P1 upon rho g pressure energy, V1 square upon 2g velocity energy, plus Z1, that is a depth, and HFS, that is a friction losses in a suction pipe. So when the water is supplied from the sump to the impeller, in a pipe there is a different losses, that is a friction losses. Okay, so energy is reduced at the inlet of this impeller, so we adding this energy, that is known as the HFS. Now what is P atmosphere? That is atmospheric pressure on a free surface of a liquid. V atmosphere means velocity of the liquid at a free surface, and it is considered zero because in the sum water is stationary, it have no velocity. So its velocity V atmosphere is considered zero. That means this term is totally zero. Now next is Z atmosphere. That is the height of free surface from the datum. So this sump level we are considering the datum. So Z atmosphere is zero. Next P1, that is the pressure at inlet of the pump, means here that is known as the pressure. Now next one is the Z1. That is the height of inlet of pump from the datum HS. Z1 means height from the center of the impeller to the water level in the sump, and it's equal to the HS, that is a suction head. So Z1 is replaced by this HS in these equations. V1 is equal to velocity of a liquid at the inlet of the pump VS. Okay, so V1 is replaced by the VS in these equations. And HF is head loss in a suction pipe. So now this all the value is putting in above equations, then after we further simplified it. So these are our equations in which we putting this value. V atmosphere is 0, means velocity at the sump is 0. Z atmosphere, it is considered as the datum, so it is 0. V1 is replaced by the Vs and Z1 is replaced by the Hs. Now, so our equation is, we are finding the maximum suction lift or suction height. That means we are finding the HS. Okay, so we simplify this equation on further way, that is P1 upon rho g is equal to, so this P1 upon rho g is equal to, so it is on the right side, so all these parameter is supply into this left side, so it is converted into this minus because its sign is plus on the right side. So P atmosphere upon rho g minus in bracket V square upon 2g plus HS plus HFS. When means when we open this bracket, this sign is converted into this minus. So this is our equation number 1. The pressure at inlet of the pump shall not be less than the vapor pressure of the liquid. Means pressure at inlet of the pump shall not be less than the vapor pressure. If it is less than the vapor pressure, then cavitation is occur. And if you want to know what is cavitations, then you can go onto the top right screen or also from the I symbol on of top right screen. Link is also available in description, and also you go to the playlist. Okay, so pressure must be above the vapor pressure of the liquid so that pump will work without cavitations. So limiting condition is P1 is equal to PV. What is meaning of PV? PV is equal to vapor pressure. So this P1 is replaced by the PV. So PV upon rho g is equal to, and the right side it is the same equations. So we moving ahead. So PV upon rho g is equal to vapor pressure hat. So instance of the PV upon rho g, we write the HV. H means hat and V means vapor. So it is known as the vapor pressure hat HV. And P atmosphere upon rho g, it is known as the atmospheric pressure hat. So it is written as the H atmosphere. Now these two term is putting in these equations. So PV upon rho g, instance of that we did written the HV. And P atmosphere upon rho g is replaced with the H atmospheres. Minus another thing is same. And we finding the suction height HS. So we convert this equation in the form of HS. So this HS, when we open this bracket, HS is negative. Okay, so it is supplied on the left side, then it is converted in the plus. So HS is equal to H atmosphere minus V square upon 2G plus the HV is on the left side, it is coming to the right side, so it is converted in the negative, so minus HV and minus HFS. So above equations is a maximum suction lift or a height. If the suction height of the pump is more than HS, so there is a possibility of cavitations. Means we are putting this value of these parameters and we get the HS, means maximum height of our suction pipe. And if we increase the suction height over this value that given by these equations, then there is a possibility of cavitations, and also it is possible the water is not supplied by the pump because suction is not take place properly. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and share with your friends.